I'm Claudia Scarlata from University of Minnesota. UVUDF would be the head of the project, is the ultraviolet side of the Hubble ultra-deep field, which is the deepest field that has ever been observed with the Hubble Space Telescope. It's a tiny little patch of the sky. We are studying how galaxies form their stars. And specifically, we discovered very recently that there is a transition in how galaxies form their star early on in the universe and how they form stars today. So the idea is to understand what is causing this transition. Specifically, right now, today in the universe, galaxies form stars very smoothly, very quietly, if you want, while back then, a few billion years ago, galaxies were way more active. They were booming with star formation. And they were also forming stars in very large clumps. We call them clumps. The end goal is to understand how we go from a smooth gas distribution to the galaxies we have today. We need to study their evolution, their formation and their evolution. And so one aspect of that is to understand how the stars form and how the process of star formation changes over time. So the research we are doing will shed light on that aspect specifically through the UV light. They do a great deal of work. So the idea is that when you have a galaxy, you have to identify where the star-forming clumps are. And that's something that you can write an automatic software to do for you, but that's never going to find the smallest clump, the most difficult one, and so on. There is the need to have help, visual inspection, first of all, and help from someone to really find all the star-forming clumps. So that's what the citizen scientists do for us. They look at the galaxies, they tell us what shape they are, whether they are nice and smooth or if they are irregulars and so on, and count the clumps, the star-forming clumps that there are in these objects. There are many. My favorite is probably the discovery of the green peas. These are very tiny galaxies. They have called them the green peas because they look like green, like literally green peas. These objects are nearby, but they are probably the best analog we have for the objects in the very early universe. They are very small, very young. We can study these objects because they are very similar to those galaxies that are in the early universe. Maybe eventually, but nobody was looking for these objects. So it was, that was a discovery that it's certainly owned by the Galaxy Zoo project. Well, one of the next questions I will be focusing on with my students here at UMN is to try and automatize the problem of galaxy classification. But to do that, we will always need the input of galaxies, of the citizen scientists. And the reason for that is the next generation of surveys like the LSST and so on, large telescope that will survey the entire sky over and over again, will produce billions of galaxies. So those numbers will be impossible even for the citizen scientists. So we are going to come up with a scheme that incorporates both citizen scientists and automatic algorithm to be able to classify the entire surveys at once, basically. It's going to be a loop, citizen scientist, automatic classification, and so on.